The history of the forks goes back long before records. And while we were putting in sewers, we uncovered remains of campfires that date back to 6,000 years ago, prior to the erection of the pyramids in Egypt. So this place has been used. As long as the rivers have been here, it's much easier to canoe down a river, walk along the frozen ice, than it is to head straight across the prairie or through the trees. So the rivers have made this a meeting place. Three different groups of people meeting here on an annual basis to make up trade alliances, intermarry, trade the goods from the forest with the goods from the prairies. And that pattern continued through into historic times. The European fur traders, first with the French regime in Quebec, and then later with the Canadian colonies, ended up coming through here. The Hudson's Bay Company, the Northwest Company, the independent traders, and La Vérendrye, who was the first recorded explorer in the area, was invited to this area by the Assiniboine Nation in 1737, and they suggested he set up a trading spot. Fort Rouge was the result. The latter two day giants in the fur trade, the Hudson's Bay Company and the Northwest Company, both used this area as a meeting place for their brigades, the ones that were going further inland. The next major aspect that occurred at the Forks was the arrival of the immigrants from all over Europe. Take the rail to Minneapolis, get on the steamboats that supplied the Red River, and get off at the immigration sheds, which are approximately 150 meters from where we're standing. The majority of the homesteaders, Icelandic, Mennonite, Ukrainian, Polish, whatever, arrived through that. The next great aspect was the arrival of rail, both rail coming north from Minneapolis, which arrived at this site in 1889, and the Eastern Rail across the river over my shoulder in St. Boniface area arrived in 1895. And at that point, Winnipeg, although it had been a village, a fur trade center, and at one time effectively the political capital of all of Western Canada under the Hudson's Bay, it became a city in its own right, the gateway to the West. And this revitalization of this former rail yard, which has existed for 100 years into the National Park, and the other areas that are Forks Renewal Corporation developing as a people place, it's turning it back to the people who are coming back to their roots. So it's a link for all of Canada, and not only just Canada, but all of Western North America. All construction on here has been mainly revitalizing and refurbishing existing buildings. The current market at one time was two stables built in 1909 by two competing rail companies, the Grand Trunk and the Canadian Northern. One of the buildings housed 120 horses and the other 100 horses. The goods would come in by rail, and you didn't have couriers in those days. The rail company would throw the goods on the wagons and deliver it out to the recipient. The building has been revitalized into the aspect of patterned after the old Winnipeg City Market. And the new tower actually is patterned after the old city tower as well in that market. We have instituted a program where members of the public, ranging in age from 7 to 87, can come down, actually excavate, work in the labs, and participate in the recovery of the archaeology. Excavating on the remains of Fort Gibraltar, the charred timbers that were left when the fort was burnt, the fish bones and that were part of the supper of the traders that lived there. And by exposing children particularly, and adults as well, it gives them a tactile sense, a hands-on sense of, yeah, there were people behind the history, and it's not just a list of names and dates, it was real people who did real things, doing their best to get along, do their job, and this is what they left behind. And even someone like myself who's been a professional archaeologist for 20 years, there still is a thrill of holding in your hand something that nobody else has touched for 100 years, 500 years, a couple of thousand years. And that's the thrill of a heritage that we're trying to get across to the public, and they're coming out in droves.
For more information about Manitoba's Winnipeg region and the Forks, you can call toll-free 1-800-665-0040, extension 325.